someone you love most has to die before you or you have to die before them. Have you ever thought of it? I said this a few nights back, that if you are married, your wife has to die before you or you have to die before your wife. If you have children, your children have to die before you or some of them, or you have to die before them, or all of you may die together. Prepare yourself for that day because it is a reality. الموت باب وكل الناس داخله. Death is a door that every single person shall be entering. There is no ways out there. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us, I will test you with taking away life. Life of those closest to you. I will take it away to test you. Do you get depressed or do you say Alhamdulillah? Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Indeed, we belong to Allah, and unto Him is the return of every single one of us. I will get to the translation of that particular term in a few moments, inshallah. Let's get to the last item mentioned in this particular verse. Allah says, I will test you with reduced or lack of or destruction in produce and crops. When you have produce, Allah says, I might destroy it. Your business, I might cut it. In order to test you, in order to give you a chance to get closer to Allah. Allah says He is with those who bear patience. Allah has really prepared a huge reward for those who bear patience. Why then do we find ourselves looking at it as a disaster rather than an opportunity to gain closeness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? After that He says, وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ. Give good news, give glad tidings to those who bear sabr, to those who are patient.
الَّذِينَ إِذَا أَصَابَتْهُمْ مُصِيبَةٌ قَالُوا إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ.
Those whom when calamity comes in their direction, they say, indeed, we belong to Allah. Whatever Allah has taken away was His in the first place. He gave it to us in the first place. We are happy with His decision. We belong to Allah. Not only this item went back to Allah, we will also all be returning to Him very, very soon. That is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's plan. And He taught us to say these words. Most of us are guilty. When we hear of a death, we suddenly say, Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. As though we're just paying lip service to it, without realizing the deeper meaning of it. We are telling Allah, I thank you for whatever your decree is, O my Creator. And I'm acknowledging that not only the person you've taken away belongs to you, everything, every one of us belongs to you, and we are all going to expire one day. Every creature of Allah has an expiry date. It will all disappear into the rahmah and the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us inshallah in every way. Those who have lost loved ones, do not despair. It is not Allah who is punishing you by taking away your loved ones. It is a test of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you are going to be going there very, very soon, including myself. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make that day easy for us. So if you have a little medical problem, don't worry. Just continue, carry on. That little pain, every time it's there, it is an elevation of your status. Thank Allah. Say, Ya Allah, cure me, but I'm not competing with your decision. I would like cure, Ya Allah. I would like you to help me. Yes, it is our duty to seek assistance. There's nothing wrong with that. But it is really wrong for us to start fighting with the Creator. Why did you take my son away? Why are you doing this to me? Those type of questions, in that case, we will not be from amongst those who pass the exam. Rather, we will come out with a certificate that has all F's on there. Fail, fail, fail. May Allah protect us. We don't want that to happen. And Allah says, I gave you a chance to write the exam. Why did you come with a certificate that has failure in it? I even sent you a book. Imagine when we have to study for matric, for example, or when we have to study for any examination, we suffer studying morning and evening up to late at night. We will even, subhanallah, we will spend hours without sleep in order to study a book so that we can pass a test to get to the next level. Why don't we study the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to pass the test to get into paradise? Allahu Akbar. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us intellect. May He grant us a sound mind, inshallah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then tells us that will be on the day of Qiyamah. But hang on, there is more waiting for them in paradise. Those who are patient, and this is why we say, when calamity comes in your direction, seize the opportunity to get close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And never ever seize that opportunity to go straight into the hands of shaitan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that on the day of Qiyamah, listen to what He says in Surah Ad-Dahr. in Jannah now. We spoke about the day of Qiyamah. Let's get to heaven, to Jannah.
وَجَزَاهُمْ بِمَا صَبَرُوا جَنَّةً وَحَرِيرًا مُتَّكِئِينَ فِيهَا عَلَى الْأَرَائِكِ.
Long verses, Allah says, we have rewarded them because of their patience with Jannah. Look at them, they are sitting back, relaxing on their recliners. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, sitting back on their recliners, sitting because of the patience they were bearing in the dunya. And patience really is a gift of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, granted to those who are given even a bigger gift, known as calamity coming in your direction, or should I say hardship coming in your direction. That is a huge gift and opportunity if you look at it that way. Because without that hardship, where were you going to be able to engage in sabr if it didn't come in your direction? If your life is easy and smooth and nothing going wrong, you need to be worried. Really, you need to be worried and concerned. Where are my opportunities to engage in a huge act of worship known as sabr? If it's not for these tests and hardships, how will I be able to engage in that? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us understanding. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then tells us that sabr is from Allah. It is Allah who gives you that opportunity to engage in sabr. Look at what he says in Surah An-Nahl.
Wasbir wama sabruka illa billah.
Bear patience. For indeed, that quality of sabr will only come to you from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from no one else. It is a gift from Allah. Otherwise, others, they will definitely be tested. Everybody will be tested. But we have two groups of people. Those who consider the test as a punishment and they get depressed and their life comes to an end. Someone dies and you die with them. Something happens, something goes missing and you go missing with them. Which means you are so depressed that your life has come to a standstill. Allah says if you want to choose that path, you will lose here and you will lose there as well. But Allah says the other path is to choose our path. To acknowledge that definitely we are in control. It is a gift from us. Patience is a gift, and realize it and recognize it. Now sometimes as human beings it becomes a little bit difficult. The reason is we have a heart. We have a brain, we have a mind, we have feelings. And sometimes a person is taken away who is very close to us. It's a little bit difficult. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, subhanallah, has taught us what to do to enhance and increase. To enhance and increase our sabr. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, you must read the stories of the prophets that we have mentioned in the Quran. And this instruction was also to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If you want to ease your problems, go and read the seerah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Read his life. Your problems will seem like nothing. Allahu Akbar. You want to ease your difficulties. Allah tells Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, go and read about the difficulties of Ayyub alayhi salam. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Sad, he says, Ayyub alayhi salam, may Allah's peace be upon him, the Prophet, he was tested so much, that Allah had to declare that we tested him and we found him to be patient. Allahu Akbar. Imagine the Creator himself is declaring somebody patient. This is unheard of. Subhanallah. Allah says it in the Quran.
نِعْمَ الْعَبْدُ.
What a great worshipper is Ayyub.
إِنَّا وَجَدْنَاهُ صَابِرًا.
We tested him in every way you can think of. And we found him to be the most patient, or very, very patient. Allahu Akbar.
نِعْمَ الْعَبْدُ.
What a great worshipper. Allahu Akbar. Look at that. Ayyub alayhi salam, I think it's our duty to go out and read his story. Because we don't have the time to go into his story now. Look at how Allah gave him and took away from him. And then gave him again. Subhanallah. Subhanallah. He passed the test. Allah says, we found him to be patient. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala really grant us goodness through his mercy. And not test us with tests that will be too difficult for us to pass. Ameen.